Welcome to part two of the Nagash painting tutorial. Now in this part I'm going to be focusing on the robes and the spirits, and I'm going to be showing you a really useful technique of how to blend colours using shades. And this technique is going to be very useful as well throughout the rest of painting this miniature. So I've been looking forward to this part, let's not waste any more time, let's get to it. The first part I'm going to paint on this assembly will be the spirits, because this will be quite a messy part, so I may as well start with this. The colour you need is Celestra Grey, and as always, give the paints a good shake before you use each one. And I'm going to be applying this using two different brushes. I've got both a large dry brush and a large brush as well. I'm going to be starting with the large dry brush, because this will enable me to cover a large area very quickly. So I'm just going to put some paint on the palette, and use the palette to make sure I don't have too much paint on the brush. If you do put too much on it once, you see, you can start clogging up detail. So it's better to apply thinner coats. So all you need to do is start painting this on to the spirits across all of it, all down here. Now, you will probably still see some of the undercoat through some of this. I mean, you can still see some around about there. That's absolutely fine. Just let this first layer dry and apply a second one later on, and you'll get a nice color that way. Now, as you get towards where the spirits meet the robe, you need to switch over to your other brush. So when you get to that point, switch to your large brush and just load it up in the same kind of way. I'm thinning it down with a little bit of water this time, just to help the paint flow a bit smoother. And there we go. So once you're ready, what you're looking to do here is bring the paint and this color to points as it meets the robe. So what I mean by that is start painting like this, very lightly, so I'm bringing it to points. Now this is just the starting step of doing the blend. So you don't have to be particularly neat with it at this stage. This is just kind of to ease in the process later on. So what you need to do now is work around all these spirits, getting this solid color. And every time you get to the robe, just do this and get that kind of, almost like a dog tooth kind of pattern there. I finished applying the Celestra Grey and it took, well, two coats, and you can see what I mean around the back here, especially about how messy this stage is. And what we're going to do now is immediately neaten this up with the next colour, and that is Incubi Darkness. Now I'm going to be applying this using two different brushes. I've got the large brush again, and I've also got a standard brush this time. So start out by getting your paint ready in the same way, on your palette here, so you can control how much is on your brush. And this time you're looking to base coat around the robes. So all of this upper area around here, good even base coat. You see immediately I'm painting over all those little dots of the Celestra Grey. And just like before, when you start getting towards the point where the robes transition into the spirits, you need to switch over to your smaller brush. So I'm jumping over now to my standard brush. I'll just get it ready. And if you just twist your brush on your palette like this, you can bring the bristles to a nice tip, and that'll really help you out at this point. Because what you need to do is copy this pattern that you've created, this kind of zigzag pattern, by painting the green over it, following it roughly. And you don't have to follow it exactly, you're just trying to create this kind of, well, like a zigzag, carrying on that dogtooth kind of pattern. And this is going to be the transition point where you're going to do the blend over it. Setting it up like this will make the blend much easier. I finished the Incubi Darkness base coat, and you can see just towards the bottom of the robe as it meets the spirits, I've done all those spikes down there, even on the inside, which you can just see in amongst it down there. The next stage is to add a bit more colour to the spirits, and for this I'm going to be doing something a bit unusual. I'm actually going to use a technical paint, Nylac Oxide, and I'm going to be applying most of this using a wash brush. So I'm going to load up plenty on my brush here, so I've got a good amount. Now this is a lot like a shade, but it's actually a little bit thicker. So when I start painting this over the spirits, which has quite shallow detail on it, you'll see it will settle really nicely and really easily and amongst all that detail there. See the effect I'm getting around here? So now you need to go around all the Celestra Grey doing this. But a word of warning for you, when you start doing it, make sure you carry on until you've done all of it. If you leave part of this to dry and pick it up later, you can get a line forming from where the paint is dry and where you're putting on the fresh paint. Now also, this stage might be a little bit messy. If it does get some spots on the Incubi Darkness, that's absolutely fine. Just let it dry, then neaten up with Incubi Darkness afterwards. Now, as you're approaching where the transition point's going to be, you need to switch your brush over. And I'm going to be changing over to a standard brush. So load it up in the same way. And what you're looking to do here is paint this across the transition, but a little bit further up. So roughly following the pattern of spikes that you've made, but just a bit further. And this is, again, going to help with the blend once we move on to that next. Now the Nihilac Oxide has dried, you can see it's given a really nice effect on all these spirits. And the next stage is to start blending the spirits with the robe. Now for this I'm going to be using a kind of glazing technique, and you need Collier Green Shade and Lamian Medium. I'm going to be applying these using a large brush, and you need to mix them on your palette. So I'm going for about a 1-3 mix. So I'm getting one brushful of Collier Green Shade there. Then I always wash my brush before I get the medium so I don't contaminate it with any colour. So for the medium, I'm looking for 3 brushfuls now. So 1, 2, and 3, and then mix them together on your palette. Now, when you're applying this, you want to be applying it thinly. So if it's running as you're putting it on, then you've probably got a bit too much on there. So use your palette to get rid of the excess shade. And then you start painting this onto the join between the spirits and the robe. So about a distance up, around about here, you just start painting it on and bring it all the way down across that transition, and quite far down as well. I'm going to go down to around about there, like that. Now, first, on the first coat of this isn't immediately obvious. You see, it's very subtle. But this is only the first coat, and I'm going to be putting on quite a lot of these to build up this blend. So what you need to do now is go around all these connections doing the same kind of thing, and on the inside as well. And each time you do it, give it about 10 minutes to dry. Now, once this is dried, we'll come back and I'm going to apply another layer, and you'll see what difference this is going to start to make. So now the first coat's dried, and you can see it's very subtle, but now I'm going to apply another coat using the same mix and applying in the same way, so still the 1-3 mix, but this time I'm just focusing it a little bit more towards that join there. So last time I went all the way down to there, the initial colour, this time I'm going to go up to about there, and the same applies on the darker green at the top. So I'm going to apply this coat to all these areas, and then once again give it about 10 minutes to dry. Now I'm applying the third layer, and you can see the effect is starting to build up now. So you just need to carry on doing this, always getting a little bit closer to the actual join, and always keeping the layer very thin as well so it doesn't run. But you've just got to keep adding layer after layer. I'm expecting this to take 7 to 8 layers to get finished, but you just got to carry on until you're happy with the effect. So what I'm going to do now is carry on doing this across all the transitions, and when you come back, you'll be able to see the finished effect. So there it is. Now it's taken a few more coats than I thought it would. It actually took 10 in the end. But you can see I've achieved now a really nice smooth blend going from the spirits to that darker green of the robe. Now the next stage is to do, well, much the same thing really, but this time I'm going to be doing it up towards the top of the robe, going into black. So I'm looking at painting between the top there and around about there should be fine. Now, this time I'm not going to be painting black at the top. Instead, I'm just going to be using Norn Oil and Lamian Medium. And the mix I'm going for is the same as before. So, 1 part Norn Oil to 3 parts Lamian Medium. So, I'll just get it ready in the same way as before. So, that's 1, 2, and 3. And then get them mixed together. So the application is just like we were doing before. So, I've still got my large brush, and I'm making sure I'm not putting on a large amount at once. Because if you do put on quite a lot at once, it can start running and blobbing downwards. You just need to keep a thin coat. So the initial ones, like before, you won't see much of a difference, but it's important to build up this gradual transition. So I'm looking at painting down to around about there, and going all around the top of the robe here, and on the inside as well. Now that the first coat is dry, I'm going to add a second coat, and this time just a little bit further to the top. So this is just like when I was doing the Collier Green Shade earlier. So now it's just a case of adding more coats like this until you're happy with the effect, always going a little bit higher towards the top with each coat. I'm expecting this to take 5 or 6 layers to get to the effect I'm happy with, but I'm just going to keep on going until I'm happy with the end result. So 6 coats of Norn Oil later, I've got to a point that I'm really happy with. So now I can start adding some highlights to the robes. Now for this, I'm going to be doing a technique called edge highlighting, and I'm going to be using 3 different colours. I'm going to start out with Cobalite Green, then I'll apply Cyberite Green, then finally I'm going to add just a bit of White Scar just to finish it off. Now the brush I'm going to be using for all of this will be a fine detail brush, and when you're getting your paint ready on your palette, you make sure that you thin it down with a little bit of water, because this will help the paint flow smoothly onto the miniature. So just get that mixture ready there, a bit too much. There we go, about that is perfect. So notice as well I'm doing this little twisting technique here to get rid of excess paint off the brush and bring the bristles to a nice point as well. Now, if I just turn around the model around, this is the best example around here. What you're looking to do is angle your brush, so you're using the side of it to take advantage of how pronounced this detail is. And what you do is just run it along these edges here, and you'll see very quickly you get a neat line of that brighter green running along these areas. So what you need to do is go around these robes now, all the way around it. This includes all the holes and everything, doing this technique to really bring out the colour. Now, as you get closer to the spirits, you need to just keep going until the green starts to disappear. So I'm looking at going to around about there. And doing this will really help bind the spirits to the robes and bring the whole thing together. Now, for this colour, when you get into the top of the robes around here, you just need to do some highlights for these creases. For this, you just need to look at how the light's reflecting off these creases, how the shade settled on it. And where it's lightest, just paint a thin line just running down them. You don't need very much, but this just helps define that shape and really bring it out. Once you've finished that first highlight, you need to repeat the process, this time using Cyberite Green. So apply it in exactly the same way, and you'll see this colour's much brighter. You need to carry on all the way down to the spirits to, once again, the point where it starts to disappear into the green for the spirits. Towards the top of the robe, though, you don't need to go all the way. You just need to go close to the top, up to about this point here is far enough. And then finally, just add a bit of white scar just to the sharpest parts of the robe, just along the bottom of it here. And this will really add to that ghostly effect that we've got going on all this fabric. So you don't need very much, just around these sharp pointed bits around here. Now that I've applied that last highlight, the robes are finished. And the next thing I'm going to concentrate on completing are the spirits. So I'm going to begin doing this by adding just a bit more volume to them by applying a shade. I'm going to be using the same mix that I did earlier. So one part Collier Green shade to three parts Lamian Medium. Now I'm going to be applying most of this using a wash brush. So get a good amount loaded on your brush and put it onto your palette. And then I'm just going to dilute it down using the medium. So that's one, two, and three. So there we go. So just make your mix on your palette. And you don't need that much on your brush because you don't want to lose control, like when we were doing the blending earlier. So when you're ready, you just need to start with a spirit. So I'm going to begin with this one in front of Nagash. And you just need to apply this over the ghost. And you see it settles nicely in the recesses and just gives a little bit more volume to it. So you're looking to paint this over the whole body of the spirit and also a short distance down the trail as well. You don't have to go that far, just to about there. Now, also, you need to apply this mix to other areas in the spirits to give them a bit more volume elsewhere. So I'm going to be switching to a standard brush now, and I'll show you what I mean on the spirits around the base here. Wherever there's little dips and recesses in the actual trails, you just need to paint some of this mix into it. So around here, for example, and like with the spirit body, this just gives a bit more volume. You'll also need to paint this around all the skeletons and skulls around here too. And once you've done this, give it plenty of time to dry. About 10 minutes should be fine. I've given the shade plenty of time to dry, and you can see what I mean. Having it on these spirits has really given them more definition and a bit more depth too. So the next thing I'm going to do to these is to highlight them. And for this, I've got Ortho and Grey. I'm going to be applying it using a fine detail brush. So just make use of your palette here to get a good tip on your brush. Just thinning it down with a little bit of water. There you go, bringing all the bristles to a tip there. And what you're looking to do on the spirits is just paint lines defining all the sharpest features on them. So on this one's face, for example, I'm looking at doing a line running across his brow, like that, you don't need much. Then just round to his cheekbone there, and on the bridge of his nose. Now, doing this means that all these features are just going to pop out from a distance, so it'll be much clearer to see them when it's on the tabletop or in your cabinet. So you're looking to do this all around the face, on the teeth, and on the hands as well, and on his arms. And also on these trails, just coming up from the back of his head here. So just like this. And with that highlight, the spirits are almost complete. In fact, there's only one more color to do on them, and that is Waywatcher Green. And I'm gonna be applying this using my fine detail brush still, and you don't need very much on your brush, just a small amount will do. And what you're looking to do here is paint this color into some of the recesses on the spirit. And you don't have to do all of them. Things like just around here behind his head. It's just a nice little splash of color that really adds to this ethereal feel of these spirits. So let's work around them now, and once you've done this, the spirits will be complete. And now the spirits are done, with the robe as well, we've really finished the toughest parts of painting Nagash. And now I'm going to start painting the details that appear on this sub-assembly. Now the first of these is going to be the sword scabbard, which is made of flayed human flesh. And there are a couple of books that use this as the cover as well, but I'm going to be coming back to all the books later on in part 4, so you don't need to worry about that for now. For doing the sword scabbard, we're going to be starting out by painting it with Bugman's Glow, and then we're going to be layering over the top of that using Kislev Flesh. After that, I'm going to shade the whole thing using a mix of Reichlam Flesh Shade and Lamia Medium. Then after that, I'll neaten up again with Kislev Flesh. Then I'm going to add some highlights to it, starting with Pallid Witch Flesh, and then finally some White Scar just for the stitching down the middle. So for Bugman's Glow, for the base coat, I'm going to be applying it using a standard brush, and at this stage, you're just looking to get a solid, smooth colour across the whole thing. So just get your paint ready, and then you're just looking to start painting this across the entire scabbard, all the way down here, even amongst all the stitching. Now, as you're getting towards the top, just be careful that you don't get any of this paint on the green that you've just done. If you do, just neaten it up afterwards. You might need to use some Abandoned Black to do that at the top here. But just take your time with this and get this all a solid colour. Next, apply a layer of Kislev Flesh. Now, Kislev Flesh is quite a thin colour, and as you're painting it on, you probably will have to apply more than one layer. Now, it's important that you resist the temptation to apply it thickly so as to do it in one go. It's always better to apply multiple thin layers than one thick layer, because you'll get a smoother result in the end. Next, apply a shade of Reichlam Flesh Shade across the whole scabbard. Now, I've mixed this with some Lamia Medium, about 1:1, so that the colour's not quite so strong. And the reason I've been using medium so much is because this allows me to dilute a shade without changing its properties. So it gives me a much smoother effect than I'd be getting if I'd used, say, water. I've given the shade plenty of time to dry, about 10 minutes. And the next stage is to go back to Kislev Flesh and apply another layer of it. Now this time I'm going to be applying this only on the sides of the scabbard just to neaten and, well, brighten these areas up. So I'm going down either side here. You don't need to worry about the stitching or anything, but you do need to put some on these little ridges that just run down the top in the middle up here. Now I'm going to start adding some highlights to it, starting with an edge highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh, which I'm going to be putting on all the way around the edge of the scabbard, so down either side and at the top here too, and also on these ridges going down the middle. You don't need to worry about the stitching though, we'll come to that next. Once that's done, the last thing to do on the flesh for the scabbard is to just paint the stitching. Now for this I've got White Scar, and you just need to very gently start dabbing the paint onto the stitching like this, so that you're not going to get any on the flesh beneath. And once you've done this side, of course, don't forget to do the other side too. Now that the scabbard's done, this part is mostly finished. There's still a couple of things to do, like the books and the belt and things like that, but we're going to be coming back to those later on when we cover them in parts 3 and 4. So when you're painting this part in Nagash, always remember to start out with the messy parts first of all, because you'll be neatening up then later on when you start adding other colours. Now I used quite a lot of Lamian Medium on this assembly, and that's because it allowed me to thin down my shades without changing their properties, so doing this I could achieve a nice smooth blend. And when you are doing the blend, remember to apply each layer thinly, let it dry completely, and then apply another one, and just keep on going until you get to a result that you're happy with. Now we're going to move on to part 3, where I'll be painting the body and also a couple of sub-assemblies as well. So I'll see you there.